Hey friends, so I wanted to go into detail on, these top 10 myths that I put in this blog post because this is something I see quite a lot of misunderstandings happening around when it comes to influencer marketing. So I'm sharing this both because I want influencers to be able to use this when they're talking to brands and agencies, because ultimately, here's the deal. The more that we can all work together, the more that influencers can effectively work with brands, and the more that brands and agencies can more appropriately work with influencers and understand them and understand their business, and the more that these two entities, if you will, can work together from a business perspective successfully, we all benefit. It's all going to benefit the consumer ultimately. It's going to benefit the business with increased sales. It's going to benefit the blogger or the influencer because they have a happy business relationship and they're making money and they're serving their audience. So let's make that happen. But let's go through some of these myths so that you on the brand and agency side can understand some of the things that are probably holding you back from executing successful campaigns. Again, I'm going to urge you to stay away from campaigns, start looking at more long-term business relationships with influencers. It's just absolutely what makes sense. But number one, one of the misconceptions that I hear first is that influencers just do what they do for fun. They're independently wealthy and don't need to be paid. Now, I don't necessarily hear a lot of folks in the brand and agency space saying, "I think these people are wealthy, like they're Paris Hilton just sitting around." But they tend to look at somebody who's making their living, or that they're full-time focused on a blog or an Instagram channel, and maybe their fitness is, or excuse me, their focus is fitness, makeup, cosmetics. It can seem to be because it's fun and casual, and creative, that it's not like a real job, and therefore it's just somebody who's doing it on the side and it's a very casual thing for them. It's just a hobby. Nothing could be further from the truth. Today's influencers, there's a reason why recent grads are saying that I think a lot of the statistics coming out are saying people that are going to college this generation are actually hoping to become influencers. It is a legitimate way to earn a solid living. It's also not cheap on the influencer side to start a blog, take amazing photography or video, pay subscription service revenue or money on a subscription basis so that you can edit your photos, pay WordPress fees, pay for a great, I mean, what am I recording this video on? I've got a tripod here, I've got my second iPhone, I've got podcast equipment here. I mean, the things that bloggers are spending and investing in for their craft, and the time that they are investing, and the employees, meaning contractors and maybe part-time employees, or in some cases, full-time employees. This is a legitimate business, and you need to understand that more than ever, influencers and bloggers are putting money and a hell of a lot of time into developing their content, which is valuable in and of itself, but so is the audience that is tuning into that content. So get away from that idea that these influencers aren't to be taken seriously, that they aren't business savvy. Certainly, a lot of them could become a lot more business savvy. I'm working on that to help them with that. But these are people who are spending a lot of money in their business. Their business is a value. Stop treating them like they're a babysitter. Number two, second myth, creating an Instagram post, blog post, YouTube video, link, sponsored tweets is easy and free. What's the big deal? I just saw this actually in a private Facebook group for women in marketing. And this woman was complaining about the rates she had to pay for influencers, basically saying, "What's the big deal?" Well, let me tell you something. I am publishing this blog post, and do you want to know what it's taking me from start to finish to write the blog post, create the images in Canva, where I pay a subscription fee every month for those images, and to shoot this video, and to upload the video, and to convert the video? I also pay a subscription for that. It will probably take me a total of 3 hours to create this blog post. When you think about what your time is worth and what a typical blogger is doing as far as the time they're spending to create content, There is a lot of work that goes into this. When people are using cameras and film equipment, that stuff isn't cheap. My DSLR camera, and most vloggers have a DSLR camera, is $500-$600. You have to pay all kinds of subscription fees. And a lot of people are hiring professional photographers. I am, most influencers are. Don't think that this is quick and easy and cheap. You are paying professionals to create outstanding content and you need to treat them that way. The standard rate, when I see people go, well, I know the standard rate is $100 per 100 followers. I don't know who created that standard, but that's not how influencer marketing works. The influencer is going to tell you what they need to be paid because, quite frankly, they have other methods of making money. And this is what is missing from the brains of so many folks in the brand and agency space. You need to understand that it's not like it was 5 or 6 years ago where influencers were dropping everything to be able to do a post on your oatmeal and get paid $150 for it. They are making money from their own ebooks, their own fitness programs, their own foodie programs, their own how to be an entrepreneur program, their podcast. They have income coming in from affiliate sales, from network marketing companies, from, again, their own products, their own subscription models. They are building their own businesses. Many of these people are millionaires in their own right. They don't need your sponsored post for a raspberry protein bar. Trust me when I tell you that that is one of the biggest things I think brands and agencies need to understand, is that if you get an influencer who has 5,000 followers and is telling you that in order to do that sponsored post or go to that event, they want to be paid $1,500, and you're going, well, that doesn't make sense based on your reach. That's because for them, they might go, well, that sounds cool, but in order for me to give up a day of my time and productivity and this, that, and the other, and for me to go leave and attend an event in downtown New York, this is what I'd need to make it worth my while. It is what it is. It's called demand. That's what you need to understand, you know? Keep that in mind. Influencers, this is one of my favorites. Influencers love getting a shout out on a brand's page. It will drive traffic. Stop offering influencers, oh, well, we'll shout out to you on our Twitter following. We'll shout out to you on our Facebook page. We have, you know, 18,000 followers. Nobody needs your shout out. Everybody, if shout outs were actually valued, don't even get me started. Nobody needs your shout out. It's not gonna drive traffic. And more often than not, the influencers are probably gonna have higher reach than your brand will, unless you're a Fortune 500 brand, mainstream brand. Stop offering shout outs. Nobody needs the shout outs. Bloggers and influencers know how to drive their own traffic. If one blogger charges $10 for an Instagram post, everyone should charge that much. I hear this logic all of the time. Well, I asked this person to do it and they did it for free, so therefore everyone should do it for free. That is the most flawed thinking I can possibly imagine. It doesn't work that way. There are millions of Instagram influencers out there, so it should be easy to find exactly what my brand and agency wants, the look and feel of the content, plus the followers, et cetera, et cetera. Let me tell you something. Having to explain to brands and agencies that influencers are not like, you know, influencers are more like unicorns than like Barbie dolls, okay? And what I mean by that is if I want to go buy a Barbie doll, I can go into the store and I can find a Barbie doll with any length hair, any color skin, any special focus or area of expertise, if you will. You know, I can find skating Barbie, business Barbie, foodie Barbie, any kind of Barbie I want, I can go find it, and it's at any store, okay? Unicorns are very hard to find. When brands work with me, whether it's for an event or for a campaign or what have you, I have to explain this again and again. There is not an unlimited amount of influencers out there. There's not some machine that is making influencers, and that if you decide you only want to pay 25 influencers $150 and you want them all to have 100,000 Instagram followers, and you want all of their posts on Instagram to have engagement of 189 or more, and you want them to be posting X amount of times a day, not have any profanity, not be working with any competing brands, not ever talk about religion, not ever talk about politics, but also have all of their content be a certain color and a certain look and a feel. And if you think that just because that's what you determined you want, that someone can go find them because you've read that there are how many, you know, users on Instagram and how many billions of people are using social media. There are not unlimited numbers of influencers out there. And for you to find the precise requirements that you want and you think you need for the price that you want, combined with the interest of those people, you know, you also just have to take that into account. You can go out and find, this is a lot of what we do, we can go find the perfect influencers for you. They might look at your product and go, I'm not interested. Or they might look at your price that you're offering and go, I'm not interested. Or they might look at your date of your event and go, I'm out of town. There is not an unlimited amount of bloggers and influencers, and that really needs to be driven home, because it's going to help you when you plan. You'll start to say yes to more that you're turning down for stupid reasons. Getting product from us should be more than enough payment for a blogger or an influencer. Seriously? No. No one's going to spend an hour creating content for you because you sent them a pair of $12 socks. And it's not really, let me clarify this too. This is not to be snotty about your product. You could have a really cool product. I wish I had this stuff here that I was just drinking. I'm drinking this, I hope I'm saying it correctly, BAI, this fantastic coconut mango drink, and it's only got 5 calories and it's amazing. So if a brand that has a low price point product approaches somebody and says, hey, I want to work with you and I'm going to send you, you know, $50 worth of product a month, it's not necessarily like that you have to have a product valued at $500 or more in order for someone to work for free. It's not strictly the value of the product. It's also the fact that when you're asking somebody to work for free, this goes back to understanding the life of a blogger. Bloggers are working with a lot. They could be working with a lot of brands, but more importantly, they've got their own business ventures. They're making money from other ventures. So each one of them is going to get to the point where they're going to say, okay, if I'm going to spend the next 2 hours of my time this Thursday, do I want to spend it in exchange for some free pineapple juice? Or do I want to spend it working on building my email list, which will make me an extra $2,000 or $3,000 next month? I mean, those are the types of things that start to happen. I remember, and I've worked as a blogger and an influencer with brands. And in the early days, I used to love getting all the free stuff. And I would say yes to everything, like a lot of bloggers will. Then you know what happens? So my closet in my office is right behind me. My closet would be filled with stuff that I needed to do reviews on, and no one was paying me for it. And I can't pay my bills with that stuff. And the pressure was on, and the PR agencies were reaching out. When are you going to do the post? When are you going to do the post? When are you going to do the post? And I realized, like, I committed to doing all this content, and it was going to take so much time, which was going to take me away from earning money. So you really have to understand that that's what's going on behind the scenes. A lot of bloggers are evaluating whether or not they'll work with you. And I hear a lot of folks in the brand and agency space talking, you know, really a lot of smack talk about bloggers and influencers as if they don't appreciate it. It's not that they don't appreciate your event or your invite or the fact that some celebrity is going to be at your, you know, exclusive event. They might think it's very cool, but they're also smart, savvy business people who go, you know what? Based on how much time I'm missing from what I do and what I need to do for my business, that's not going to deliver the ROI that I need. And they are learning to turn things down. You have to understand this. This is a better way for you to engage with bloggers and influencers. We're getting to the end. Influencers don't have job. We kind of already addressed this before. So they don't need the money. The reason they don't need your money, this says influencers don't have jobs, so they need your money. They don't need your money, and the reason they don't need your money, meaning when you're coming to them and offering them $100 or $50 or $12 for a post, they're making their own money from their own efforts. The only thing that's gonna, I hear this a lot from brands, non-mainstream brands, maybe non-Fortune 500 brands. The only thing that's gonna help my business is to hire a celebrity influencer. If they have over 1 million followers and they mention my name, I'm gonna get a lot of followers. Maybe you might get a lot of followers. But if you are thinking that those celebrity followers who follow you because they've been told to enter a contest are going to ever come back to your Instagram account or engage with you on a regular basis or buy your products, you're mistaken. That is not a solid long-term approach to building your business and generating revenues. Lastly, influencers really don't move the needle and aren't worth paying. I've already worked with two people who work for free. Why would I ever pay a blogger? If you are not understanding how much influencers of all reach, this is not just influencers who have 100,000 or more Instagram followers or have a quarter of a million blog traffic on a monthly basis or even more. It's not just the high reach influencers. In fact, the stats show that when Instagram, for example, on Instagram, when people have, I believe it's 1,000 or less, the engagement is the highest and it goes down, it trickles down as you increase in followers. So you get your highest engagement with somebody that is that they're following when it's less than 1,000. Brands are missing out on using these micro influencers and cast a wide net. That's the best, in my opinion, in my experience, that's the best approach. Working, you can do it twofold. I strongly recommend brand ambassador, long-term brand ambassador programs, but further, there is something to be said about getting your product in the hands of people who can try it, review it, share it on their social media, because those folks that have 1,000 to 5,000 followers are very influential in their local area. And that's how you get a groundswell without spending a lot of money, because those are the types of folks who will sometimes work for $100 or $50 because they've never gotten those job opportunities. That's a missed opportunity for quite a lot of you, and you need to reconsider it. So please, 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 if you're a brand or an agency and you've been falling under the spell of some of these myths, please, please, please stop. This is for your own good. I'm not creating this video to embarrass people or to, you know, bash brands and agencies. This is I'm doing this because straight real talk is going to help both brands and agencies and influencers work together for the greater good. So if you're a brand and agency, brand and or agency, and you have questions on anything, leave it in the comments, use the contact me form, get back to me directly. I'm happy to schedule a call and walk through some of this with you and help you with your next efforts. If you are an influencer and you're hearing this and saying amen, feel free to share this with any brand that you're working with or any agency that's approaching you, because they need to hear this, I know. On the other hand, in closing, let me say this to you as an influencer. Not only do you provide value and you should be charging higher rates and you should be being very careful and selective about the sponsored opportunities that you choose, and you should be creating your own ways of earning multiple streams of income from your blog and from your Instagram profile and so on and so forth, but handle yourself with professionalism. Learn that the ultimate goal of working with any brand is to drive sales. Do not make sure that you're dedicated when you take on a sponsored post, that you are going to only work with somebody who you have a critically genuine interest in their products and you are willing to just do a crazy great job for them. Don't take this lightly. Don't take everything I've said and say, well, there you go, I'm gonna charge high rates. And I mean, in other words, I'm trying to discourage diva behavior. I'm trying to encourage women and influencers behaving in a manner that is professional, being paid what they're worth, and making a whole heck of a lot of money from a business online. So treat yourself like a business. Treat your engagements with brands and agencies in a professional manner. When that dialogue is professional both ways, everybody's gonna benefit, and that's what I hope. But again, whether you're a brand or an agency, or if you're an influencer and you have questions, please leave a question in the comment below, or don't hesitate to certainly use the contact me form and schedule a call. Thanks so much, everybody, and I hope this was helpful. I will see you soon.